Reza, you're outside the United Nations in New York, where, as I said, there's a hunger strike and a protest taking place. Give us a sense of what's been happening.
Yeah, let's go ahead and show you the scene here. A hunger strike, a three-day hunger strike, starting this morning at 8 a.m. right in front of the UN building here in New York City. What you have here is about 60 Iranian celebrities. You have movie stars, singers, songwriters, authors, professors, all here on this hunger strike in sort of the support of the opposition movement in Iran, and they're calling for the release of the hundreds of detainees. These are prisoners arrested after the controversial election on June 12th. A lot of big names here, none bigger than Googoosh, a legendary singer who arrived here at the hunger strike about an hour ago. She was mobbed by her supporters here and fellow Iranians. Here's what she had to say when we spoke to her.
I hope that the word can hear us, and United Nations do something for our people and for our young generation and women.
That was Googoosh, who's speaking to the gathering right now. She has never, ever been on a hunger strike, but she says she's ready to go. The organizer of this event is political dissident Akbar Ganji, who's been on an 80-day hunger strike when he went to prison in Iran in 2005. One of the most well-known political dissidents. So a gathering of big names here in the Iranian community, trying to put pressure on the UN, trying to put pressure on the Obama administration to help get these detainees free back in Iran, Aisha.
Reza, Googoosh was just saying there that she hopes that the world will hear them as they mount this protest, but do they think that anyone in back in Iran, certainly among the hardliners, will pay attention to this?
Well, I asked her this, Aisha. I asked her if the Supreme Leader at this moment is worried about this type of gathering a half a world away, and she said probably not. But she is convinced that with the help of other influential here, they can put pressure on the international community, they can raise awareness, and they say every bit helps. Every bit of attention of what's happening in Iran helps, and it also energizes the movement over there. They say once they realize that they're being watched, that people outside of the country are helping, that will give them a boost to continue the movement, Aisha.
All right, Reza Sayed, joining us from outside the United Nations in New York. Reza, thank you as always.